guys, let's go through real quick. When I apologize and I'm grabbing an ankle, right? As I'm dropping down, I'm pushing. As I'm dropping, I'm pushing. And I'm going like this. I'm trying to get his foot past me and his head down to the ground so I can at least land inside. So I'm not picking up the leg and driving. I'm not picking up the leg with both hands. I'm literally sitting down and dropping him down. Okay? Traditional ring pick, yeah, I'm picking it up, tree topping, running the pipe, whatever. This is not that, okay? We're trying to get this motherfucker on his back, okay? So it's this. Go pick him up and then try to push. As you're going down, you're pushing, okay? 3, 2. Most of the time, when you use a wrist lock, people are quick to pull out. What that does is creates distance, creates space between me and my opponent. So maybe we can get a scramble, maybe I can get up, maybe we can change the position that we're in, right? But if they're not fast enough to pull out, then we can submit someone with a wrist lock, okay? So the first one we're going to do is for full guard, okay? People have their hands up here, okay? If you've been looking for a while, this is really good show for wrist locks, okay? I've done this before. What I'm gonna do is start grabbing 2-on-1, okay? A lot of times when you grab 2-on-1, they're gonna pull their hand out, their free hand, right? And try to rip stuff off, okay? When they do that, that's when we can start attacking. If they don't, we can use this to start going for arm bars, right? But we're here, and we're pulling, and they start grabbing my hand, right? What I'm gonna do is, say she grabbed my top side hand. There's two different ones. So she grabbed the top side hand, there's one option. She grabbed the bottom side hand, there's one as well, okay? So she grabs the top side hand. What I'm going to do is I'm going to pull this wrist and pretend I'm going for this. When they do that, they usually pull the right hand out and I go here. Okay? And I go and I smother both. When I do that, I turn my palm up. And now I'm going to go here. Okay? When I'm in this position, as his elbow is kind of flared out, I need to make sure I get that elbow down to my belly. Okay, belly, cup, whatever. You're just swatting on the center line now. Okay, then when we're here, I'm gonna start pulling in with this arm into my chest, pushing down with this hand, and then I'm gonna sit up and crunch. What that does is it pushes the elbow down into my gut. Okay, so I go down into my chest, down toward her, and then I sit up, okay? What I'm doing when I sit up, what I'm doing with this hand is I'm squeezing, turning, and pushing it down. We want to try to compress all those smaller bones in the hand, squeeze them together, right? Then start turning them, manipulating them. Once you squeeze those little bones together, they don't fucking move freely anymore, right? So it hurts, it's painful when you start moving them. And then you want to start bringing her wrist backwards at the same time. Okay? So here, I'm turning. I'll even grab my wrist here. You guys see that? From the bottom side hanging right at the top one. I'm turning and going down at the same time. Okay? A lot of times if you can get your top side arm the blade over the wrist, you really cut into their wrist here. Okay? That's what we're looking for. You can get angle. Okay, so hands on your partner's chest. I got 2-on-1. Okay, so you grab my top side hand. I'll start pulling this, right? And as she starts pulling out, I go here. And I really turn to the side, so it's in, or towards my stomach, right? My belly button, yeah.
The ring on.
Okay? Same setup with the bottom side hand. So she grabs here, and she grabs the bottom side hand. Right? I'm gonna turn. I just turn with that hand now. Okay? So here, she grabs the bottom side hand. I let go, turn, go here. Okay? I'm full. Can you guys see my fingers here? You guys stop seeing my right hand fingers? As I'm pushing her wrist this way with my right hand, my fingers are revving her wrist as motorcycle drop. Okay? Yeah. So I'm here, going down, now I'm full. Okay? Let's go to slot number one. Okay? Try with both hands, right? She'll grab the fucking top one.
Here, and I'm
I'm just ripping away. I'm throttling, right? Yeah, this one's just holding her in, right? A lot of times, so, okay, this is my ABC. This is what we're talking about, game plan, right? If you weren't here, we're talking about game plan too. My A, Americana. My B, wrist lock. A lot of times when they feel wrist lock, they'll shoot their arm up in the sky. Okay, they'll either put it here or they'll put it here. Once they do that,
straight up, spinning arm. Armbar, they usually connect their hands, right? Straight from the bicep slicer, right? Get the bicep slicer, if not, if we're here, elbow, and then if I want to grab a wrist lock, I'll grab a wrist lock here. Okay? So there's my ABC. If we're talking about game plans, that's what I'm going for. If I'm in side control, that's just three easy setups to create a scramble, for me to mount, or for me to get a submission right off the bat. What's your question, Logan?
Are bicep slices real in competition?
It depends on the competition.
Depends on the race. Like this one coming up, it's not going to come out as well.
Okay, so, side control. On the head and arm. I'm going to transition to double over, right? I want to use my chin to start pushing down on the wrist and seeing what she wants to give me, all right? She's got three options of what she wants to give me. Because my hand, if she's going to let me pin it down, my arm is already ready to grab an Americana. See that? So I can get this down, I'm already ready for an Americana. If she's going to let me, she's going to pull the elbow in, pull it down, right? I'm blocking and I'm attacking, right? And if she shoots it up on that side or the other side, I'm just going to use underhook and pull her up and go for spinning armbar, or I can mount her easily. Because if I mount her, I already have this arm under jack from her arm triangle.
Where is Aiden? That's what we're talking about, contingencies, right?
I might not be good at side control, but if I know I'm killer at mount. So I might, all I need to do is get her to move so I can get to mount. Right? Once we get to mount, that arm is already up. It's already under jack for me. I get on top, arm triangle. S mount for armbar or Americana right off the bat. Okay, so I just went from ABC to mount ABC. Okay, that's what we're talking about, game plans. Okay, yeah. So any questions on these wrist locks? No. Back take from the mount.
Scoochie this one.
All right, back take from the mount.
Alright,
I'm mounting my partner, okay? I want to take the back. What I like to do is use my chest to start straightening, okay? A lot of times when I see you guys in mount, you guys aren't crushing as much as you could, okay? When you're, okay, you're fighting someone and you guys worked your ass off to get on top of them. You have to make it suck for them as much as physically fucking possible, okay? I'm on top of you. This is the most dominant position in jiu-jitsu, right? Minus leg locks, you guys can't do that. But this is a real dominant position. So when you guys are like this, what the fuck, what are you doing that for, man? I could smother her. So,
sorry, bro.
So when I get on top of you, I'm like this. I'm like you to tap just from suffocation, okay? They call that mother's milk, right? If I can get her head in the middle of my chest, right, and crush down, and you get a suffocation tap, they call that mama's milk, okay? And it works. Okay, in mother's milk position, right? I'll grab your nose. Okay, so you might not be able to see, but I'm pinching her nose with my bottom side hand. That's legal. You can smother someone, you can cover their mouth, you can pinch their nose in jiu-jitsu. It's legal. Okay? It's not the nicest thing to do. But how bad do you want to win? Okay? So smothering someone, crushing someone is what you want to be doing when you're in the mouth. I see a lot of you guys like this.
Just fucking floating on top of them.
No point. No, no good here. Okay? When you're in that position and you're smothering them, one, you can start pushing down their elbows, right? So if I start pushing down their elbows, and get it down on the ground, I can start underjacking. Right? When I'm underjacking here, now I can go for Americanas, arm triangles, arm bars, things like that. They know that, so when I'm pushing down, they're gonna pull their elbows in. Okay, and they'll go like mummy. Right? Yeah, go mummy up here, right? A lot of times too, if you want them to mummy, you can start going for a punch choke or a Ezekiel choke, right? That'll get them to bring their elbows in, right? So they can like start locking here, okay? Once they start doing that, that's when I can start scraping on my chest. This elbow I feel is deeper, right? So from here on top of her crushing, I'll start pushing, and then I use my chest to start scraping. Okay, if I can get her at 45 right here, and I'm 45, I can take her back. Okay, all I have to do is shove my knee with power.
Yo,
you watching, Broski?
I am.
All right, all I have to do is shove my knee under her back, and now I can take her back easily. Right? I could. This is. I don't like. Don't do this one. Okay. Don't try to roll. I see people do this, and they try to like. Roll their partner and then they get caught like this. Don't do that. That's not gonna work. This is gonna happen. They're gonna get on top of you. Okay? So you're here, you get the knee under, right? And my chest here, I'm picking her up. So I'm gonna grab this hook right here and I'm picking her up. Okay? And then I slide under. After I slide under, I use that momentum to give me a nice body primer. Okay? So we need elbows in for the back take. Elbows down for arm attacks. So game plan again. What are you good at? Are you good at back attacks or arm triangles, Americanas, arm bars, things like that? Right? Try to figure that out, what you're good at. If you're really good at arm bars and shit like that, you're pushing the elbows down and trying to get under to underjack them up, right? If you're bad at those and you're really good at rear naked chokes, you're trying to attack her so she pulls the elbows in. When they pull the elbows in, that's when we can start scraping them to the side, okay? Depending on what your game plan is, right? Over here, first things first, smother. They might be dead tired, and if you just put your sweaty ass rash guard, stinky rash guard, on their face, they might just tap. They're like, screw this. I want to go eat a pizza. And they just tap. Okay? I've done that before. Okay? So that might work. Okay? But first things first is smother. Mommy's nose. Oh, I will pinch your nose, right? I want to get these elbows in. If I get the elbow in, I push it to the side. Okay? After I push it to the side, I'm just going to scrape and then bring the knee up. Now my knee's behind her. I use this hook, and I kick her up. So I'll even post this foot. Post here, kick her up. Right? I could just fall. Alright, that's one option. I pick her up, I'll shoot my leg across. Okay? And then I'll fall with her to get a body triangle. Okay? Whenever you do a body triangle, the lock needs to be up or down, guys. Okay? There's a foot lock it can keep you with when it's down and bottom. That way. Okay? So foot lock is always the top. The lock is always the top. For the body triangle. Okay? You guys got that?
Yeah.
What's up?
One more time, please.
Umlauts. Yeah, yeah. Smother, number one.
You just punched the tricep. I'm sorry.
Yeah, I'll punch the tricep.
I was going to add, what was those two shows?
Don't worry about that. We're coming back today. Okay. So we're here. Stinky armpits. Da-da-da-da. Smother, right? They pull elbows in. Punch, right? Or you can use your leg, right? Then we're using our chest, shoving her over, getting this knee behind her. Okay? When she goes belly down, just take her back. Right?
Easy peasy.
She's gonna try to be fighting into you, right? But she can't because you have that knee behind her back. That's when you need to get the hook under, right? And that's when you need to lift, slide, take her back. Okay? Or you can just lift and fall to the opposite side. Cool? 3, 2, go. A couple minutes on this.